हेलो, आई एम डॉक्टर मंदार दातार। आई वर्क फॉर अघरकर रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट इन बायोडायवर्सिटी एंड पैलियो बायोलॉजी ग्रुप। आवर लैब इज बेसिकली फोकसिंग ऑन यूनिक हैबिटेट्स ऑफ नॉर्दर्न वेस्टर्न घाट्स। सो नॉर्दर्न वेस्टर्न घाट इज द नॉर्दर्न टेल ऑफ वेस्टर्न घाट विच इज ग्लोबली रिकग्नाइज एट बायोडायवर्सिटी हॉटस्पॉट। सो वॉट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन नॉर्दर्न एंड सदर्न एंड सेंट्रल वेस्टर्न घाट्स? So southern and central western ghats are comparatively wetter regions, while northern western ghat is a drier region. Northern western ghat receives less amount of rainfall. 4 months of rainfall and amount is less as compared to its southern and central counterparts. So northern western ghat is that way fragmented landscape, and it's kind of an open landscape. So this fragmentation and dry nature of northern western ghat gives unique opportunities for various habitats to evolve, various niches to develop, and plants can acclimatize, colonize, and evolve into new species in these new habitats. So as the region is dry, it has many unique species. So as an attempt to understand endemism of northern western ghat, since it is a floristically well-surveyed region, there was no synthesis available for endemism of this region. So in our lab, we made an attempt to study endemism of this region and publish a checklist of these endemics. Dr. Aparna Watve, decade back, pioneered this work here in Agarkar Research Institute. We are taking her work further and trying to understand community ecology of these habitats all across northern western Ghats. All these habitats, cliffs and plateaus are classified globally as under the term rock outcrops. So rock outcrops is a very common term and, amongst geologists, and presently we are focusing on endemism of these species, endemism of flowering plants growing on these outcrops. So endemism is a very important criteria for declaration of a particular area as a biodiversity hotspot. So concentration of endemism is the one, and the habitat loss or the human anthropogenic pressures that particular area faces are the criteria for determining or recognizing a particular area as hotspot. So our lab is presently focusing on endemism of this particular region. The region was floristically very well surveyed, but there were no ecological synthesis as such available for the endemism of this region. So we recently published a checklist of exclusive or local endemic flowering plants of this region very recently, and that checklist is an attempt to understand or decode the endemism of our region. The list yielded as many as 181 taxa of endemic plants. So for a common man, endemism is just a term, but for a biologist, it's a very important concept. And what is the significance of this endemism in our region? And you may ask, why this such a small region, which encompasses Western Ghat part of Maharashtra and Goa, has as many as 181 taxa of endemic species? The reason is very unique. The seasonality, which is distinct from the southern and central Western Ghats, and the habitat specificity of this region. So there are two unique habitats in this region. One is plateaus. We have basaltic plateaus in the northern part of Pune. We have lateritic plateaus in the southern part of Pune, as well as we have low altitude lateritic outcrops located in the Konkan region. In addition to these lateritic plateaus, we have vertical basaltic cliffs, which are unique in their plant species composition. Both these cliffs and plateaus globally are known as outcrops, and this is rock outcrops is a very common term used in geologists, but for botanical sake they have many unique species in them. So what is all unique about these species on these cliffs and rock outcrop? As the seasonality governs the habitat and seasonality governs the floristic diversity of this region, we have 4 months of wetter period, 4 months of precipitation, and 8 months of drier period. So in these 4 months of wetter period, you receive maximum precipitation and you have these favorable conditions for growth of the species. And remaining 8 months, there is like lacunae of water, even a single drop is not available to species growing on these habitats which I'm mentioning, plateaus and cliffs. And then so there is this seasonal shift of favorable and unfavorable conditions. So under favorable conditions, they have to flower, they have to produce fruits, or they have to disperse seeds, and these seeds will remain as a propagule for the remaining period. So if you talk about life strategies that are governed or dominant in this region, you have therophytes as the most important and common strategy. Therophytes are annual plants that complete their life cycle in a short period. Short period in the sense in monsoon period. And remaining period, for remaining 8 months, they remain as seeds. So as soon as advent of next monsoon, they germinate and start growing their next life cycle. In addition to therophytes, we have dominance of geophytes. So geophytes have a totally different strategy where they have underground perinating organ in the form of tuber, corm or rhizome or bulb. And this underground perinating organ, which remains throughout the year underground, is the propagule for them. So through this stored food in these propagules, in this underground perinating organ, they can immediately sprout in the next monsoon, start their flowering, and they can liberate the seeds. So geophytes and therophytes are the most common strategies of this particular region. Over the years, taxonomists have described large number of species, novel species from these habitats. So these novel species form bulk of this checklist. So taxonomically, they are well surveyed, but their ecological recognition as a distinct habitat in Indian context is a very recent narrative.
So Western Ghat is backbone of peninsular India. Many rivers that originate in Western Ghat quench the thirst of human societies and provide water to agriculture of peninsular India. So one way, entire human society that lives in peninsular India directly depends on Western Ghats. But considering the present urbanization-induced climate changes and human pressures, Western Ghat is in danger. Through our work, we are trying to build evidence that will help in conserving this globally recognized but locally neglected unique region. Western Ghat has many treasures yet to be decoded. Northern Western Ghat especially has dry and challenging habitats. Considering the current scenario of climate change, we may get many leads for our future agriculture from species that grow in these challenging habitats. Agarkar Research Institute, through our work, is making honest attempt in this direction. Thank you.